Steve, we saw Canada's real estate market wrap up 2022 with price declines. What is the expectation for the new year?
I mean, I think that the market seems to be expecting, you know, lower prices. I think that that's where buyer sentiment is right now. I think that interest rates, while they might have peaked out for this cycle, given the latest rhetoric from the Bank of Canada, I think that they're going to be elevated next year into 2023 in terms of what we're used to. So I think that's going to apply some downwards pressure, because ultimately I think borrowing power just remains restrained, right? I mean, you've got a stress test that looks like, again, it's probably not going to be altered here at OSFI's upcoming meeting. And so, you know, people are going to have to get stress tested with a seven in front of it. And that ultimately is going to restrict purchasing power.
Tell us about inventory levels and the speculation of where that will be at for the new year.
I think that's the big wild card, right? I mean, if you look at inventory levels, I mean, they're subdued. They're really low. I think they're, you know, for November is our most recent data point. You know, over the last 10 years, these inventory levels are basically hovering around sort of what we normally would see in a bull market. So we haven't seen the flood of distressed sellers coming to market like everybody was sort of expecting. I still think some of that's going to come. We're definitely getting some distressed calls. I think, you know, we're going to have our usual uptick in the spring. We're going to get a spring inventory balance, and that's going to be interesting to see, because I you know, it really comes down to what's buyer demand look like in the spring, especially with mortgage rates probably still having a five in front of it. So that's going to be the question mark. Is I think right now low inventory levels are actually supporting home values and home prices. We've seen a leveling off in sort of the decline in prices over the last several months, and I think that is predominantly due to very tight levels of overall inventory for sale.
Will affordability still be a factor here, or will home prices drop low enough to become affordable?
I think we're still going to be talking about affordability next year. I think we'll still be talking about it 5 years from now. I think that if you run the numbers today, mortgage rates, again, in the fives, home prices, yes, they're down. You know, nationally, we're down, what, 15% since peak. But the cost of carrying a home today is still actually more expensive or less. It's not more affordable, let's put it that way. So I think we still need to see a further decline in prices, slight easing in interest rates, and then maybe we get some improvement in affordability. But I think overall, we're still going to be talking about unaffordability in the years ahead.
How do you look at the condo market versus detached market for the new year?
The detached market has historically, at least in Vancouver and the GTA, has historically led the market. So it's led the market on the way up. It's led the market so far on the declines. So I do expect condo market might be in maybe for more pressure than the detached market. The detached market, like I said, it's already gone through a nice correction. The condo market, I worry that we'll see more of the investors. That's where more of the investors play. And I think a lot of the conversations we're having today is, hey, I was breaking even on my rental condo. Now the variable rate mortgages are up 400 basis points. I'm now losing, you know, $300, $400, $500, $600 a month. And per BC or per strata laws, per rental restriction laws, I'm not allowed to increase my rent more than 2%. So what do I do? And so I think a lot of investors, some of them are opting to actually hit the sell button. And I think that we'll see maybe a little bit more pressure on the inventory side in 2023.
Let's take this conversation into the rental market now.
Yeah, I think that rents, pretty much any property manager you chat with today will tell you that rents have had a tremendous run over the past 18 months, and they ultimately peaked in the summer in terms of rent growth. So we're seeing a flattening of rents, certainly not declining at this point, but I think that it ultimately is going to be tied to the labor market. There's certainly been, you know, growing calls anyways for potential recession in 2023. So does that impact the labor market, you know, slightly higher unemployment rate, et cetera? So I think the rental market, I don't think they're going to see a lot of growth there. I understand that people are opting to go into the rental market versus, you know, purchasing today. We certainly have a lot of population growth, immigration growth expected for next year. But I think ultimately the labor market's probably going to take a bit of a hit. So, I mean, my personal guess is I think that we're going to see sort of a balancing out in the rental market.
From your vantage point, what are some of the themes or trends that we can expect to see for 2023? We've seen bidding wars in the past, the virtual tours. What are you seeing?
I think the conversation in 2023 or the media headlines, I think will be focused around some of the issues in the variable rate mortgage space. We know the Bank of Canada has come out recently, talked about trigger rates, and over half of them have now hit their trigger points. And obviously a 400 basis point move in your variable rate mortgage is nothing to sniff at. I mean, it's a big move, and it's impacting quite a few households. So I think we're going to see some discussions around that. We're certainly seeing an uptick in court-ordered sales, particularly more for private lenders, B lenders, people that are on sort of these one-year terms that are renewing at substantially higher rates. So that's going to be an interesting conversation. I think the other thing to kind of keep an eye on as well is a bit of the pre-sale market. You know, people that maybe entered into a pre-sale agreement a year ago, year and a half ago, and all of a sudden, again, you have to go qualified at a stress test of 7.5%. I think some of these buyers, we're certainly seeing some stories of it, not able to qualify to actually complete and close on these units. So again, I don't think it's a huge widespread issue, but I think there's going to be a lot more anecdotal stories coming out, you know, people that were ultimately caught offside with the huge move in rates here.
Anything that you're watching from the government with respect to intervention or incentives?
I think that we've seen a lot of the policy changes more recently. We know the 2023 foreign buyer ban is in place as of January 1st. So we're seeing a little bit of activity towards the end of the year here in terms of some foreigners trying to make transactions before that freeze goes in place. But ultimately, I don't think it's going to have a large impact on the market. You know, if you look at official statistics from the BC government that's been collecting this for, I don't know, 4 or 5 years now, foreigners accounted for about 1% of total transactions in BC. And so that, while that sounds low, I think from a headline perspective, the reality is a lot of them are, you know, permanent residents, or they have some sort of employment situation here in the country that sort of bypasses the foreign buyer ban, so to speak. So that's kind of what I'm looking for. I don't, you know, OSFI's coming out later this week with potential updates to their stress test. I think that sounds like they're going to keep it in place, but maybe what I think we might see is the removal on renewals. So the ability for people that are locked in with one big bank, that they can go to another big bank to get a more competitive rate and not have to get stressed. As I would be surprised if that doesn't get changed. So that's probably a positive impact for people that are renewing here.